Russell Craig "Rusty" Hammer was an American stage, film and television actor. He is best known for portraying Rusty Williams, the wise-cracking son of entertainer Danny Williams, on the popular ABC/CBS situation comedy Make Room for Daddy, from 1953 to 1964. He reprised the role in three reunion specials and the sequel series, Make Room for Granddaddy, that aired on ABC from 1970 to 1971. Career. Born in Tenafly, New Jersey, Hammer was the youngest of three sons of Arthur Walter John, Sr., a men's shirt salesman, and Dorothy Hammer, a former silent film actress. He had two elder brothers, John and Walter. As a child, Hammer was nicknamed Rusty because of his red hair and freckles. Due to his parents' involvement in community theater productions, Hammer and his brothers also began performing in stage productions. As a toddler, Hammer memorized and recited stories and performed skits for service club luncheons, women's clubs, and church groups. In 1951, the Hammers moved to Los Angeles, where Arthur Hammer worked as representative for a manufacturer of men's sports shirts. Shortly after arriving, Hammer's elder brother John was discovered by an agent while performing in a local stage production in which Hammer was also performing. The agent signed both boys to a film contract. The following year, Hammer won his first acting role in the 3D Western Fort T, starring George Montgomery and Joan Vohs. In 1953, entertainer Danny Thomas' secretary saw Hammer in a stage production and was impressed by the child's talent and charm. She suggested that Thomas audition Hammer for a role in his upcoming sitcom Make Room for Daddy. Thomas was also impressed by the six-year-old and cast Hammer as his precocious and quick-witted son Rusty Williams. Thomas later said of Hammer, "He was the best boy actor I ever saw in my life. He had a great memory, great timing, and you could change a line on him at the last minute and he came right back with it." Make Room for Daddy debuted on ABC on September 29, 1953 and, while critically acclaimed, garnered poor ratings. After three seasons, the series moved to CBS, where it was retooled and retitled The Danny Thomas Show. The retooled version quickly became a hit with audiences and was a top 20 hit for its remaining seven seasons. During the run of The Danny Thomas Show, Hammer attempted to launch a singing career. He first performed a song in a 1956 episode of Danny Thomas entitled The Talented Kid. In 1959, Hammer released his only single, a rocker ballad called Two of a Kind, written by Wally Gold and Aaron Schroeder, through Mercury Records. The single was a commercial failure and Hammer never released another single. By late 1963, The Danny Thomas Show had garnered 5 Primetime Emmy Awards and was still ranked in the top 10. However, Danny Thomas announced that he had decided to end the show in order to produce and star in other projects. After the series ended, 17-year-old Hammer enrolled at Palisades Charter High School, but had difficulty adjusting to public school as he was accustomed to being privately tutored on the set. Shortly before graduating in June 1964, Hammer granted an interview with reporter Bob Thomas. He stated that he intended to continue his acting career and hoped to branch out into dramatic roles. Hammer said that he was under consideration for roles in several television series including Mr. Novak, Arrest and Trial and Ben Casey. Hammer also said that he planned to attend college on the advice of Danny Thomas, whom he considered a second father since his own father had died in 1953. A year after The Danny Thomas Show ended, Hammer reprised the role of Rusty Williams in the reunion special The Danny Thomas TV Family Reunion, which aired on NBC. On December 27, 1966, Hammer underwent emergency surgery at Santa Monica Emergency Hospital after sustaining a gunshot wound to the abdomen when a gun he was carrying in a shoulder holster slid out. fell to the ground and discharged. Hammer was carrying the gun after having just returned from an overnight hunting trip. After recovering, he appeared in a second reunion special, Make More Room for Daddy, that aired during a segment of the NBC anthology series The Danny Thomas Hour, in 1967. Throughout the mid to late 1960s, Hammer continued to attempt to transition into adult roles and, according to Danny Thomas, enrolled in acting classes, but was unable to land any acting jobs. By the end of the decade, he had grown increasingly bitter and depressed over his waning career. To support himself, he began working for a messenger service in Los Angeles and later worked as a carpenter's apprentice. Hammer's only post-Danny Thomas show acting role was a guest spot on the CBS sitcom Green Acres, that aired in November 1969. In 1969, Hammer again reprised his role as Rusty Williams in a third reunion special, Make Room for Granddaddy. The special aired on CBS on September 14th. Due to the ratings success of the reunion specials, ABC created a weekly sequel series, also titled Make Room for Granddaddy, for their fall 1970 schedule. The series premiered on September 24, 1970, but failed to catch on with audiences. Make Room for Granddaddy was cancelled after one season. It was Hammer's final acting role. Later years. In the 1970s, Hammer moved to southwestern Louisiana where he worked on an offshore oil rig for Exxon and delivered newspapers. In 1976, he relocated to Derrida, Louisiana to be closer to his ailing mother, Dorothy, who was suffering from Alzheimer's disease and lived with his elder brother John. John Hammer had moved to the area and opened a cafe where, in his final years, Hammer occasionally worked as a short-order cook. In October 1981, Hammer reunited with former co-stars Danny Thomas and Angela Cartwright. The reunion was televised as part of the ABC special What Became Of, that aired on October 25th. Death. On the night of January 18, 1990, John Hammer found his brother's body in his trailer home in Derrida, Louisiana. Hammer had shot himself in the head with a .357 Magnum revolver. John Hammer later said he believed that his brother had remained bitter over his inability to transition into acting as an adult. He also said he believed that his brother's chronic and debilitating back pain and their mother's illness had contributed to Hammer's depression. He stated, "He hasn't really been happy since his early 20s, but he didn't show any signs of this happening. It was just all of a sudden. He was a very unhappy, very confused young man. No one does something like that if he isn't confused. I've heard of a lot of child actors who have become unhappy with their lives after they've left the industry." Hammer's body was cremated and no service was held. Legacy. On February 8, 1960, Hammer was awarded a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame for his work in television. His star is located at 6323 Hollywood Boulevard. Hammer's suicide raised awareness of the potential mental fragility of child performers and inspired fellow former child actor Paul Peterson, formerly of ABC's The Donna Reed Show, to establish the support group A Minor Consideration. The group seeks to improve working conditions for young actors and assists former child entertainers in making the transition from past fame to adult life. Filmography.